All right. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for coming. We're here today to talk about risk management and how we can better utilize it for the state of New York to save money for everyone. Senator Valesky was supposed to be here with us today, but he had a scheduling conflict, so it'll be us here today. But as we're in the midst of a budget and we are trying to work out and get reasonable spending and get spending under control for the state of New York, at the same time provide vital services for New Yorkers, we're working on plans on how we can bring costs down. And today we are proposing an idea that we think will go a long way in terms of managing costs and provide reliable services to the people of New York. Risk management is one of the many tools that should be used by New York to manage its assets, control costs, and reduce potential liabilities. Put simply, risk management is about proactively seeking out areas that expose New York to liability, harm its property and its citizens, and it's about implementing smart decisions so that any negative effects or losses to the state are minimized or even prevented altogether. Each year, New York State faces exposure to liabilities that cost New York hundreds of millions of dollars, from court claims, insurance costs, missed days of work, repairs, and workers' compensation. Workers' compensation alone is costing New York in comp claims over $23 million a year. A perfect example is the Court of Claims issued over 250 claims totaling over $80 million costing the taxpayers in New York over $80 million. So we're here today to propose the development of a central office, an office of risk assessment and management that would combat these costs by focusing on risk management for the state of New York. Such a strategy is commonplace in the private sector. Many large companies and small firms use risk management to get their costs in line throughout the state of New York and throughout this country. And it's been used so successfully that many states have what we're proposing in place right now. This is a practical, common-sense approach to reducing damages against the state. And more importantly, it'll go a long way to protecting our residents. It'll help prevent against damaged property. It'll help prevent against injuries for all New Yorkers and also for people that come to this great state as tourists. People come far and wide. So we want to make sure we limit the liability as much as possible. So with that, Senator Klein will now discuss the specifics of this proposal.
Thank you, Senator Carlucci. I also want to welcome Assemblymember Jonathan Bing. One of the best and the brightest in the Assembly. I had the privilege of serving with Jonathan when I was still a member of the Assembly. I want to thank Senator Carlucci, Senator Savino. This is, a very simple, smart approach, and I think the result will be the state once again can save money, thus saving the taxpayers' tax dollars. The Office of Risk Management is in New York State, I believe, is long overdue. This is not creating another bureaucracy. This is merely taking a smart and efficient approach on how to identify ways that we can save money in different aspects of our government. It's interesting, and it's worth noting, there was similar legislation that was put forth about 10 years ago, which was actually vetoed by the governor because they put a price tag on the Office of Risk Management that would have cost $500,000. This is not going to be a budget item because we're going to actually pay for this and actually have this office placed within the Office of General Services, so we're not creating a new agency. Also, the person who would be the risk manager would be paid by the savings that would be derived from starting this office in the first place. As was said earlier, but I think I want to elaborate on it, when we take a look at the Court of Claims cases against the state of New York, which have been growing each and every year. Over the past 4 years, they've actually skyrocketed. When we see different types of insurance claims going up, when we see, and this was part of a study we put out earlier, workmen's compensation claims going through the roof, it's incumbent upon us in government to take a step back and ask, why is that happening? I think if we take a smart approach and implement this Office of Risk Management, we'll be able to do just that, to take a good hard look at vulnerable aspects of our state agencies, which are vulnerable to lawsuits, and be able to solve the problems before they happen. I know we're going to get into the area of what other states have done, and I know I said this last week. Unfortunately, other states are already taking the lead on this and saving the taxpayers millions of dollars each and every year. According to our calculation, within the first year, we can see $50 million in savings, which would be expanded to about $150 million by year three of the implementation of the Office of Risk Management. I think the time is long overdue to actually do this. And when we're grappling with our budget deficit right now, and by the way, we're probably looking at the negotiations that are taking place, which are maybe even as little as $50 million, this is something that needs to be part of the budget discussion. This is something that needs to be part of this year's budget so we can start saving the taxpayers money immediately. I'd now like to turn it over to Senator Bings. I'm sorry, Ben, Assemblyman Jonathan. Yeah. Assemblyman Jonathan Bing.
Good afternoon. I'm Assemblyman Jonathan Bing. I represent the Upper East Side in East Midtown Manhattan. It's my pleasure to be playing the fifth floor of the Capitol for the first time and to be here with Senator Klein, Senator Savino, and Senator Carlucci regarding this legislation. I will be introducing a same-as bill in the Assembly to the legislation that Senator Klein has introduced in the Senate. As Senator Klein mentioned, we know that this legislation can work because it's worked in other states and it's worked successfully in other states. States like Georgia, Florida, Arizona, Washington, and Texas have painted a clear picture of how beneficial an Office of Risk Management can be to residents and save their state's money, millions of dollars annually. A few examples: for Texas, in 2010, their Office of Risk Management cost containment measures resulted in nearly $70 million in savings. In Arizona, their risk management efforts reduced excess insurance expenses by approximately 15%, which resulted in the savings of more than $1.7 million. Georgia has reduced accident costs by 14%, which amounts to $800,000 worth of savings after implementing a program that sought to reduce preventable vehicular accidents and predicts the potential of $5 million more in savings in the first 5 years of the program. Florida has found recent success and saved approximately $12 million in 2009 through risk assessment. Washington State is perhaps the best example of long-term success. In a state with nearly a quarter of New York's annual budget, over 10 years, risk management has saved Washington State over $365 million in that 10-year period and continues to help them find problem areas and realize more and more savings. Risk management has also proved to be a successful tool to reduce costs in the private sector to such an extent that it's considered best practices to have a risk manager, and many companies do and have found it to be successful. However, one aspect of private risk management that often falls short in public risk management is that of an information and communication. In the private sector, there's often a clear channel of communication between the risk manager and other areas of the economy or business. However, on a state level, there is no clear structure right now between or any entity in place in order to share information regarding risk strategies. This bill would change that. And I will now pass it on to my colleague and government Senator Diane Savino, who will explain in more detail how badly needed and how beneficial this bill will be for New York State.
Thank you, Assemblyman Bing, and welcome to the fifth floor of the Capitol. I want to thank my colleagues in the IDC, Senators Klein, Carlucci, and, of course, Senator Valesky, who's not here with us today, for bringing forward another idea of how we can find ways to better serve the taxpayers of the state of New York and do things better in New York State. As we know, here in New York, we have hundreds of companies that manage to deal with their own risk and others' financial risks every day. We have great resources at our fingertips here. Nowhere is that more apparent than when it comes to risk management. Under the bill that's being preferred by Senator Klein and Assemblyman Bing, those experts and that talent can be contracted by risk managers to ensure that New York has access to those exceptional tools and resources that we need to save the state millions every year. As it's already been mentioned, the Court of Claims has issued over $85 million in payouts in more than 258 claims in the past year. That doesn't take into consideration the rising costs of workers' compensation claims and insurance costs for New York State. Those are in the billions. A strong Office of Risk Assessment and Management is critical if we're going to cut those costs and put taxpayer dollars to better use. This bill integrates and strengthens the use of risk management in a holistic way by providing services to the state and local governments and proactively treating and mitigating risks to the citizens of this great state. As Senator Klein said, we could save $50 million in the first year, $150 million in the next 3 years. Imagine what we could do if we had an extra $150 million. How we could provide better services to the taxpayer. If we had that money available to us right now, we wouldn't have to worry about whether or not we're reducing services to daycare or to seniors or to school children. The anticipated drastic savings, which will be in the hundreds of millions each year at no cost to the state, is self-apparent and cannot be understated. The bottom line is let's be proactive. Let's prevent risk. Let's find waste and enhance the goals set out by Governor Cuomo in his executive budget. This creation of an Office of Risk Management in the Office of General Services is an opportunity that is both fiscally and socially responsible and should be implemented during this tough fiscal time. Who's next? Back to Senator Carlucci.
Yes. Thank you, Senator Savino. And now we're very fortunate because we have a couple of experts when it comes to risk management. I'm going to introduce them. They're going to speak, and then we'll take any questions that anybody has. The first is Nathan Backus. He's the spokesman of risk and insurance of the Risk and Insurance Management Society. So, Nathan.
Good afternoon. On behalf of the Risk and Insurance Management Society, I would like to thank the Independent Democratic Conference for inviting us to speak in support of Senate Bill 1029A, which would create the New York Office of Risk Assessment and Management. RIMS is a not-for-profit organization representing more than 10,000 members worldwide, with over 600 members in the state of New York. We represent industrial service nonprofits and governmental entities. RIMS has been involved in the crafting of the legislation, and we are extremely grateful for that opportunity. This bill will incorporate enterprise risk management principles into the state's risk management structure. We have seen examples. We are seeing more and more that risk does not always come in neat and orderly packages. We have seen examples of this in the recent earthquakes in Japan, the political turmoil in the Mideast, or closer to home, the disruption of government functions in the state of Wisconsin due to the debate over public employee collective bargaining. It is becoming increasingly apparent that risk must be managed across the whole of an organization and not in segmented or individualized areas or agencies. Enterprise risk management is no longer a foreign concept for most organizations, and it has become an essential piece of a successful business strategy. The creation of the Office of Risk Assessment and Management will be a tremendous step forward toward incorporating this strategy into the state of New York. Once again, I would like to thank the Independent Democratic Conference for inviting us to speak today. We look forward to working with all parties to ensure that New York has in place a risk management structure that is both highly effective and efficient in managing the state's risk portfolio. Thank you.
Thank you, Nathan. And now we'll hear from Marilyn Rivers, who is a member of the Board of Directors of the Public Risk Management Association. Ms. Rivers.
Good afternoon. On behalf of the Public Risk Management Association and over 600 members of the Risk and Insurance Management Association in New York, I would like to thank the Independent Democratic Conference for the privilege of supporting them on Senate Bill 1029A, which would create the New York Office of Risk Assessment and Management. As a RIMS member and a director of the Board of Public Risk Management, I serve with my fellow risk managers from Georgia and Wyoming and Arizona and California and have the pleasure of working with them and serve as an advocate on the importance of effective risk management within the public sector. A centralized and streamlined risk management system within the government decision-making process mitigates the exposure of risk, reduces costs relating to those risks, and improves services offered to the public at large. The consolidation of risk management leadership efforts and the mitigation of risk into a single office have proven effective throughout the country. Communication is improved, operational effectiveness is increased, and the cost of doing business is reduced, which we're all looking for in these tough economic times. Coordination of the risk management efforts through one single office here in New York State will enable us to collectively measure the state's risk tolerance and improve upon its existing risk mitigation activities. SB 1029A is a proactive approach to addressing New York State risk concerns. The integration of risk management activity into the framework of the New York State government offers a multidisciplinary approach to the state's business enterprises and promotes improvement in government processes and transparency. Risk management and the mitigation of risks offer opportunities to take control of our individual and collective destinies by educating our employees, our business partners, both on a state, federal, and international level, and our communities to cost-effectively manage our available resources and capitalize upon them. Once again, I very much would like to thank the Independent Democratic Conference on behalf of PRIMA and RIMS for this opportunity and for allowing us to work closely with them in drafting this legislation. We stand supportive of the effort and are ready and willing and able to assist in making this a successful endeavor for New York State. Thank you.
Thank you, Marilyn. Now we'll take any questions that anybody has.
On topic?
Well, I have a quick one. How did this idea all of a sudden come about? Aside from Senator College, you've all been in the legislature for many years. Have you been thinking about this before, or you just did someone approach you?
This is legislation that we introduced at the end of the last session. We weren't able to get it passed, and we thought it was more appropriate to have it brought up again during the budget process.
No, but how did it come to your attention at this time and not earlier in your legislature?
It was actually when I chaired a task force on government efficiency. We're always looking for ways, you know, to save the taxpayers' money.
Could you explain a little bit more about the initial costs for expanding this office, and would that also mean hiring new people?
It's actually one person. It would be within the Office of General Services, and it would have a risk assessment manager, and that would be it. And that salary would be paid for by the potential savings.
So why is legislation for something like this? Why can't the current office that's set up right now, you know, just be designed to, you know, increase what's needed?
They probably could. As I said, you know, the last effort failed, and I believe that it failed during the Pataki administration because there was a $500,000 price tag on establishing a new office. We thought that it would make much more sense to keep the concept intact, but have the Office of General Services, which actually presently has the risk assessment for insurance already contained within the Office of General Services, just makes sense to do a full-blown risk manager within the office. It probably could have been done, but I think sometimes you need the legislature to move the executive branch along.
One risk manager would save $50 million a year?
Yes.
Is that what happens in our states, too? Is there one person, a one-person office? Is that...
Could you speak on what goes on in
the It's actually, risk management isn't about one person. Risk management is about using the resources that are available throughout the continuum of government. You want me to keep moving this way? They're telling me. Sorry. Risk management and public risk management is about using the resources that we have, but communicating and tapping on the expertise of whether it be law enforcement or the OGS or NCON, the New York State Division of PESH for the Department of Labor. It's using all of those resources, but learning how to work together to achieve efficiencies. So it's not a new idea. We've been doing it throughout the country, and actually the EU is a little bit more far advanced with respect to crossing the lines of government throughout Europe because they've embraced the practice. So what the bill is trying, or what the idea is trying to offer, is it's not adding layers of government. It's making layers of government work together to achieve the efficiencies, because we're probably doing the same thing in different tiers of government. What we're trying to do is say, hey, stop, wait. We all benefit collectively. As individuals, we belong to a team, but collectively we're the state of New York, whether we be at the local or the county or the state level. This opportunity is an opportunity for all of us to get together and to be a part of who we really are, because we set the standard for risk management. We have Wall Street. We have the collective intellect that folks look to for guidance, and we're doing it in the private sector, we're doing it on a local level. This is an opportunity to cost effectively show folks what we truly are.
You know, getting back to the example that I gave earlier of the Court of Claims, you know, when we see a spike in judgments against the state of New York, something as simple, and I think I forgot the state that actually did it, I think it was Florida, you know, just took a look at state vehicles. Are they more dangerous? Do they have bumpers on the cars? Are we taking advantage of, you know, training anyone who has a state vehicle and making sure they don't get into as many accidents? you know, that's how you can reduce costs. Presently, there's no one doing that in the state of New York.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Anything else?
Thanks.